Hey guys, my name is Noora. I'm from Printful's marketing team. Today we are filming at our fulfillment center all the way in Riga, Latvia. And joining me, I have a very special guest, also all the way from Germany, Kamil from Kornit.
Hello, my name is Kamil. I'm working as an application specialist for Kornit now for 4.5 years.
Cool. So we're going to be talking a little bit about Kornit today. For those of you who don't know, we use Kornit machines to print all of our direct-to-garment apparel. So think t-shirts, sweatshirts, tank tops, that kind of thing. So we'll be talking a little bit about the printing process, going over a live demo. And before we dive in, Kamil, why don't you tell me a little bit about Kornit? Maybe the origin of the company, your brand values, accomplishments.
Kornit was founded 2002, so it was born about 17 years ago. We just started as an ink manufacturing company. So that's also just one of the key values which we are. We are a solution provider because we are just developing the ink, all liquids, all everything which is just part of the process, including the machines, including software.
And what specific solutions do you bring to the market with Kornit?
Our specific solution is the one-step process solution. Meaning that we can take almost any garment which absorbs water, that's one of the key attributes which we need to have, and print directly onto it. So we're just applying on the fly our spray, our fixation, which is our pre-treatment, and it's inside the machine. Mm-hmm. And so from starting the print job until the fulfillment, it's just an extreme short amount of time and gives you an extreme versatility and flexibility.
So where do you see the future of e-commerce going, and how does Kornit fit into that bigger vision?
The whole fashion industry and the whole development just changes from pre-producing large amounts of garments, large amounts of design, which then just stand still and waiting in the retail shops. We just want to give customers like you the opportunity to just print on demand what is actually needed and already purchased. So, for example, if you have a beautiful design, you can have all the variations of colors, all the variations of sizes without the need to have a huge stock. Because you just can offer it to your end customers. Everybody can just express themselves just by their design. And without technology, we just make it possible without any additional effort.
Yeah, and I think we see that as well. Customers are avoiding the like big box retailers, and they're really going for more the like unique small business, interesting design concepts. So I think you guys fit in great there. All right, so how have Kornit's machines and printing models evolved over time since your creation 17 years ago?
Well, we started with a classical 4-color machine just for white t-shirts. That was a long, long, long time ago. Since then, the continuous evolution was just heading more and more into industrial states. So from a single pallet solution, we went to machines with dual pallets, so you can just, while one pallet job is printing, already prepare the second job, until we had dual pallet machines with separated bridges, so one can print white, the other one print the color. So we have overlapping print times, so which ends up in a more efficient and continuously better production flow.
Sometimes customers might notice a faint vinegar smell when they first get their packages that comes out after washing, but that smell comes from the fixation agent. So can you tell us a little bit more what that does and why we need it?
Basically, we need the fixation agent because we are printing in a wet-to-wet situation, meaning we are applying a water-based ink drop directly onto the garment. If you wouldn't have our pre-coating, which is in our case just this water-based agent, it would just directly be drawn into the garment. We are still evolving it and continuously developing our inks, so the latest version of our fixation agent doesn't have this vinegar smell anymore because we changed a couple of ingredients. In the end, these small stains sometimes are just a side effect of the actual garment manufacturing before, and sometimes a chemical reaction can appear. But usually after the first wash, everything is off. I mean, if you think about it, we're just jetting a small ink drop onto a liquid surface and it just stays in place, which is a little bit impressive.
I think so, yeah, I agree. So how does the color profile of your print file affect the end result?
In the end, we have two different worlds. We have on the one side the digital world, meaning that the actual artwork, so every single color has a certain value. And we just want to transfer this value into the color space of our printing machines. We have machines with 4 colors plus white, we have machines with 6 colors plus white. The more colors you have, the more you can actually reproduce. So in terms of color consistency, a good and adequate profile of the machine onto a specific garment is just the best way to go. It just gives you control over your reproduction.
Why is it important to order a color swatch before you create your designs or print your designs?
The way how color is displayed on a screen and how it's actually printed, these are just two completely different worlds. I mean, it's like Venus and Mars. so you just can't directly compare one to the other. RGB or monitor colors are just light emitting colors. So the more energy I apply, the brighter the color is going to be. In the printing, it is the opposite way. So the more pigment or more color I add, the darker the color gets. So there are definitely always differences. One very easy way to overcome this and just to judge or design by the actual result of the garment is just by using color swatches. So in this case, you already know what the perception and the actual reproduction of the color is going to be on that particular garment. Because it also makes a huge difference if you're printing on a natural colored t-shirt, on a t-shirt with optical brightness, a super white t-shirt, a thin or a thick white t-shirt. So even that changes dramatically the appearance of colors.
So switching topics a little bit now, can you tell us about white underbase? What is it? Why do we need it?
White underbase is absolutely mandatory if you want to print on dark or colored garments. Printing on white t-shirts is very easy. It's straightforward. It's just applying some inks. And that's basically because they already define the color. If you, for example, have a yellow t-shirt and you want to print cyan on top, and you wouldn't use a white underbase, the appearance would be green, because cyan plus yellow just equals to green, because we're just absorbing different parts of it. We just want to block the garment color to remain all the colored ink on top, so that the perception of that color just remains as it is. Depending on the garment, the white layer needs to be thicker or thinner, and especially in semi-transparent parts, we just want to utilize the actual garment color. So a white underbase is absolutely mandatory, and there's literally just no way around.
All right, so how does the machine know when it's supposed to apply a white underbase?
Well, the machine is just taking a look at the original input image and judging by the luminosity of every single pixel and every single color. The luminosity is a value of the actual lightness of the color. So the lighter a color is, the more white I need to make it visible. The darker colors, for example, on a black t-shirt, I actually don't need a white underbase on a black t-shirt for black ink on top.
So now you guys know about Kornit, who they are, who Kamil is. And we've talked a lot about the technical side of things, white underbase, fixation agent. So now it's time that we go see this all in action. And we're gonna take a look at a live demo and show you how it actually works in practice. So let's head over. Okay, so we are standing here next to one of our Kornit printers. And before we actually print a shirt and show you guys how that looks, Kamil, why don't you tell us what are we looking at here?
Sure, I'll be delighted. So in the end, just to give you a little closer overview, I'll just lift the hood. Actually, we just can do it because it's just not printing. Okay, this is the core part of the machine. Below our print heads, and our secondary ink tanks. What's special about this machine is that we have the white and the colors onto one bridge. So in that case, we just can print always just one job after the other. On different systems, we have split them onto two bridges, but that one is totally fine. Basically, what makes this generation special, it's the R series, is the recirculation of the print heads. So in that case, we have two secondary ink tanks, and so we just continuously keep circulating the ink through the print head and through the tanks.
So is that good in terms of ink efficiency, lower waste, that kind of thing?
Lower waste and lower starvation of the printheads. Because, I mean, we're using water-based ink. And every time the printheads are just exposed to the air, they start to drying out. And we just want to prevent that one. So this is why we just also just keep them circulating and rotating. The second advantage is sedimentation. Because we have a solid pigment inside the liquid solution. And probably if you've ever seen the glass water with sand inside, after a time, it just settles down. But we just keep it continuously going.
You mentioned water-based inks. Tell me about that. Is it better for the environment?
It is way better for the environment. The thing is that with pigments, you get the biggest or best brightness in terms of the color reproduction. And water-based because we just want to have a sustainable solution. Everything which is part of our process is just eco-friendly. It's certified for direct skin contact, even for newborns and children. So if it's certified for that, it is not that harmful.
So what else can you tell me here? Are there any other fun facts?
Sure. One of the most interesting things is a little bit here at the back. Just need to come around. This is actually our spray system. And that one applies on the fly our fixation and preparation directly onto the garment. So the pad is just moving all the way back in. It is spraying, wiping off, and then immediately start printing.
Then I guess we can actually print something.
Exactly. Pen is now going in.
So this is the fixation agent that's going on now?
Exactly. Right now we just already applied the spray and fixation, and we're just applying now the white underbase. That one is critical and mandatory just to get poppy and vivid colors on top. Because otherwise, like we said before, yellow shirt, cyan color, it would just fade away. And especially on black shirt, you just can't see it. The good thing is that while we're just printing now in the color passes, the machine is just waiting and timing itself before it starts the second print.
Okay.
So we have an overlapping time. So we always have the same time difference between a spray and actual printing. So actually, usually the machine waits for the operator and not the other way around.
So this is very intuitive. It already knows on its own what it's doing.
It is, yeah.
Okay.
We are working based on setups and templates, so we can just assign different setups for different garments or even different design styles if we have small logos or full-size print photorealistic images. And it's just for continuous production. It's for industrial production. So yeah. The more it runs, the better it is.
Yeah, so then we can keep up with customer demand, we can fulfill more orders and
exactly.
Be even more efficient with sending
Absolutely,
products for
yeah.
customers.
The good thing is that after the print is finished, we just need to put it into the dryer.
Okay, and why do we need to do that?
That is actually the actual curing. So the fixation or fixation agent is not actually bonding the ink, it's just stabilizing it while it's printing. The actual
okay.
curing and the bonding of the ink to the garment is happening inside the dryer just by applying heat and time.
How long does the drying process usually take?
For dark garments, minimum 7 minutes, between
so
7 and 9.
It's different for light versus dark garments? Why is that?
On the light garment, we have just one layer less,
okay.
because we're just printing only the colorings.
So and it's the underbase that adds an extra layer that needs
exactly.
more time?
Okay. And we are using way less fixation. So in the end, we just need this extra time to evaporate all the liquid and all the fixation.
Okay.
That's basically it.
So here is the finished product. Why don't we grab it from the dryer?
Always just be careful, it's still a little bit warm, so because the dryer is just drying the shirt at 160 degrees.
Okay.
But it's still less than the pizza in the oven. And the good thing is, that one is now ready for shipments. So there's no additional step needed.
Okay, just fold it, pack it, and ship it, I guess.
Exactly, yeah. But one of the greatest thing about our technology is there's the whole fixation, which was just a massive...
The garment was like soaking basically
exactly,
when we took
yeah.
it off. Okay, and now it's completely dry.
It's completely gone because it's just mostly just water, which just evaporates in the drying process. So that's a very good advantage.
Yeah, and the colors look great too, dry. They're nice and bright.
Absolutely, and also just the amount of details. That's what digital printing is.
Yeah.
Not just printing a square, just printing out fine details. Things that you would like to see in a retail store, for example.
Exactly, yeah, this is retail ready. So here it is, finished t-shirt. The design looks great, the colors pop. Thank you so much for showing us how this printer works and walking us through the whole process.
It was a pleasure indeed.
And thank you all for watching. I hope this was super informative and useful for you. If you liked this video, then feel free to leave a like, subscribe to our channel, follow all of Kornit's channels as well. They have amazing content. And if you have any more questions about printing, the printing process, then feel free to leave a comment and we will answer.